Joining us once again on tonight's Big Get, we have Todd Davis, former NFL and Denver Broncos linebacker. Todd, I know you were watching that game with all of us last night. Mick and I love to keep things very positive, so it may have been an L, but I want to know what you liked about that week one look.
You know, there was a lot of things to like about that week one gameplay. I really loved the offense. I know that they had a couple bad plays when they got down there close to the goal line, but they beat the Seattle Seahawks in every offensive category as far as running the ball and passing the ball. They really were unstoppable moving the ball around on the field. So I think that's definitely a positive to take away from the game. We cleaned up some mistakes. We cleaned up some communication, some penalties, really focused on ball handling and keeping the ball in our possession. We could be pretty talented.
When you have a Monday night football game and it's on national television and some 20 million people are tuning in to watch, and then the national media also comes into the conversation, and when you have the ending like you had on Monday night, take us into the locker room of what's discussed, because obviously to the media, you have to be like, hey, we trust our coach. We trust our players. We win together, lose together. Is that what happens in the locker room, or is there a little bit of dissemination amongst the players being like, what kind of happened?
No, I think you definitely have to keep that same message, whether you're talking to the media or it's truly how the guys feel. You have to have faith in your coaches and the coaching staff that they're making the best decisions for you and that you guys are on the right path. And it would be a little bit more dissemination if it was week 10 or 11 and we can't seem to get things right. This is week one. And, you know, there has to be a loser in every game that we play. You know, the way that week one goes is not the way your season's going to go. I think there's a lot of veterans in the locker room that know that and still are keeping faith and keeping strong that they're going to have a great season.
From the outside looking in, there's kind of a feeling of like, okay, that game's behind us now. We've been talking about it forever. Now we can get to football. Do you think that that's how the team is feeling right now? Like, okay, the show's over, all the hoopla. Now let's get down to it.
Yeah, they're finally able to take a deep breath. I know a lot of guys felt the pressure of that game. Russell Wilson coming back to where he has spent 10 years, they wanted to perform well for him. So I feel like maybe they were reaching a little bit. That's where you see some of the over-aggressive penalties that were called and the plays that just didn't seem to come together. Guys are really pressing. They saw the attention of the game. They wanted to make big plays for Russell Wilson. They wanted to help him shine. I think they were doing too much. Now they can really, you know, settle down and get into this season and how they're going to be as a football team.
As a defensive guy, I'm sure you were going crazy in the first half with all the missed tackles and mishaps. But it seemed in the second half, you know, Randy Gregory got the strip fumble on DK Metcalf. Bradley Chubb had two big sacks. From a defensive standpoint, was that just a matter of it being the first half and just being a little bit antsy? Do you feel like the defense now is in a good place? And did you see enough in that second half that will allow this defense to be a top five defense this year?
I definitely love the second half from this team. Look, they came out. They didn't play well. The communication was all over the place. Remember, it was our first time as a full unit playing together. They didn't play in the preseason. And I feel like that's one of the biggest keys that you get from preseason is how are we communicating? How is my breathing so I can tell other guys what I need from them or the play call? There's a lot of things they didn't get to work on during preseason. But you see the transition from the first half to the second half. They were way more relaxed. The communication was on point. And I feel like that if they play like that all year, they definitely can be a top five defense.
Obviously, the big headline today, Coach Hackett talking with the media the morning after saying, yeah, we should have probably gone for it. Do you, Todd, as a former player, like a coach taking ownership like that and really going back like, yeah, I would have done it differently the day after?
Yeah, I love that he puts it all on me. You don't have to blame anybody else. It was my decision. I chose that direction for my team, and I stand behind it. I also understand that, you know, hindsight is always 20/20. Yep. Of course, he would have liked to go for it on there. I personally think he should have. I mean, you bring Russ over, you pay him $250 million. Those are the moments that we brought him here to have and create. So I would have liked to see him go for it right there.
Coming off a loss, what is the message within the locker room when you have a team that now you expect to beat? Because we look at the Houston Texans and the last couple of years, that franchise really has been sky falling into the ground. When you're coming off a loss and you're playing a team that you know that you're superior, do you take the anger of that loss into that game? And how do you put out of your head we're the favorites to go against this team?
Yeah, you definitely have to take all the aggression that you're feeling, all the frustration that you have for the missed opportunities you have on Monday night and bring it to Sunday. I think it's so important for them to really focus on themselves during this week. You know, of course, game plan for the Houston Texans, that's number one. But you have to focus on the communication, the ball handling, all the things that we did wrong that really hurt ourselves. Because to be honest, the Broncos lost that game. I wouldn't say that Seattle beat them. The Broncos more so lost it. So they just want to make sure that going forward, they're not the ones causing themselves to lose.
12 penalties, two separate one-yard line fumbles. To come out of there and losing by one with a chance to win it in the end, I mean, is there a lot that you can of positivity that you can take from that game, you think?
Sure, there's a lot of positivities. I mean, even to be in that position where you could win the game after such a crazy four quarters, you know, that's a positive statement right there. The team fought to the very end. They didn't give up. Yes, they made mistakes, but they looked really good on offense. They cleaned things up in the second half on defense. I think there's a lot of positives to take away from this game. And one of my biggest positives is Jerry Jeudy. I know there was a lot of people that had a lot of things to say about this season and what he needed to do to perform to show that he was worth it. Man, I know that he led the league in separation targets last year, so it was just a matter of him getting the ball. Yeah. I think that he's going to have a phenomenal year, and I can't wait for him to do more.
And now we can, like, take a breath, right? Like, the buildup of Russell Wilson going to Seattle, all the noise from the outside, and now they get to come home and play at Mile High. As a player, when you get to have the home opener, how exciting is that to be able to go home, play in front of the hometown crowd, and now you're coming off playing in a hostile environment where you lost? How much of a relief is it for this team to come back home and play at Mile High?
They're so excited to be back. They're going to be so much more at ease, and I feel like on point for the first home opener. And the greatest thing to me is that the energy of the city is so great when the home opener is here. You can feel it. You see people in the grocery store. Everybody's excited to see you play. Everybody's been waiting for months to see Broncos football back at home. So I know the stadium's going to be rocking, and I look for the team to have a lot of success.
Last one for you. Last week we were talking about Lumen Field, how loud the 12s are. I want to know what makes Broncos country and playing at Mile High so hard for visiting teams. We know the altitude. We know all of that. But, I mean, that place is rocking. It's tough for other teams, right?
Yeah, that stadium is rocking. Our fans are some of the best in the world. I feel like they just do a great job of staying intrigued in the game. They're locked in. They know when to be quiet when Russ or Peyton is operating, and they know when to get loud when that opposing quarterback is on the field. And I like you spoke about the altitude. I love that altitude video right around fourth quarter, and they put it big on the screen and let people know that people pass out and people can't breathe. I think it plays a little bit into the psyche of those opposing players. So I appreciate them showing that because I feel like it helped me out in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. A little secret weapon playing at Mile High. All right, Todd Davis, thanks for joining us once again. Hopefully we're talking about a win this time next week, huh?
Yeah, let's do that.